Hi, welcome back to the Shtick. We're here to always talk about things that are of very much interest to the community. And one of the subjects that we always like to emphasise is education and how to make the world a better place. And one of the people who's involved in that whole shtick is a fellow called Harrison Rosen. Hi, Harrison.
Hey, how you doing? Thank you for having me.
Thank you. We're on Zoom to Sydney. And we're going to talk about your involvement with the Susan Wakil Foundation.
Absolutely. What would you like to know?
Well, firstly, I just wanted to say that you've just finished a law degree, and it's a double degree with media as well.
Yeah, that's correct. Finished up about a month ago after a long and treacherous journey.
Yeah, well, now you've got a job. You're working in a law firm, which is where you're sitting at the moment.
That's correct.
Your real interests are around social policy or public policy and advocacy. What does that mean?
I guess what I'm most passionate about, or what I've been most passionate about over the course of my degree, is helping people find the ways in which they can make a contribution and helping them to facilitate that. In particular, young people. It sounds vague, but in the context of the fellowship, it's become quite concrete.
And how did you find out about the fellowship?
So the fellowship started in 2017, and I guess at the time they were scratching around for the kinds of people that they thought might be interested in it. And Ernie Friedlander, who was involved in the organising of it, a stalwart of the community in B'nai B'rith here in Sydney, tapped me on the shoulder and tried to explain what it was and what it was going to be. And at the time, I kind of had no idea what they were proposing, but in 2018, I decided to jump on as a fellow, in large part because the person that was running it at the time, Raphael Menjum, was someone that had led me at Beitar when I was in the youth movement when I was, 14 or so. And I had a really, really incredible year. It was, not to be hyperbolic, but it really changed my life, and it was really, really positive. And so a couple of years later, when the opportunity came back to get involved myself as a staff member, I jumped at the opportunity because I hoped to be able to help facilitate the kind of experience that I had for other people.
Wonderful. Because it is a student leadership program providing a nurturing platform for Jewish students to learn how to make an impact. It's all about making an impact on the community and society as a whole.
Yeah. So the program kind of has, it tries to balance the abstract with the concrete and the practical. So over the course of the year, the fellows will go on retreats and we'll have workshops where they'll hear from industry leading experts about how change happens. We break it down into its component parts. They go and meet with the nation's leadership in Canberra. They hear from people who work in think tanks and as lobbyists and all across industry and the economy. And then also they're given a platform to try and do something themselves. So over the course of the year, they take on a social change initiative, a project, those have ranged from issues that focused on homelessness to Holocaust education. And so over the course of the year, they get this really interesting balance between learning about what change looks like and how it works in theory and getting a chance to experience it in practice.
I had a chance to read some of the profiles of the students, and I was so impressed with the kind of people that they've been able to get in there. Apparently, there are 7 from Sydney, 7 from Melbourne. Is that right?
That's absolutely correct. One of the things that we pride ourselves on is really the calibre of the people that have been through the fellowship. It's remarkable every year who we get in. And it's not just that they're an incredible kind of person. It's the diversity of the kinds of people that we get as well. I don't know if you read, but this year for the first time we've got someone studying astronautical engineering. Obviously, every year we have lots of future lawyers that find that they're interested in the kind of stuff that we talk about. We've also had medical students and people studying the whole gamut of academic disciplines. And it's that kind of breadth and depth of knowledge that gives the fellowship its kind of its incredible flavour.
Yeah, one of the things I haven't mentioned yet is that it's under the auspices of the Australian Union of Jewish Students, and you've been involved with that while you're at uni.
Yeah, absolutely. So my involvement for the first time was through the fellowship. I kind of got a sense of what all just was. Before that, I thought it was just, falafel handouts on the lawn at UNSW, and I got a sense of what an incredible organisation it is and how much it's able to do and also provide for the Jewish students on campus. And it's been a really the fellowship, I think, has been a really incredible connector between Orgis and Jewish students on campus, providing a platform for people that, like myself, that might not otherwise have been involved in Orgis to get involved. And then also on the flip side, providing some really important training for some of the Orgis leadership to help them go from more junior members of the organisation to people that have sat on the national executive.
It's wonderful. I think I have a lot of faith in the future of our community by looking at the kind of people that have come through. And this is just a little nutshell of the people, and that it really is an elite group, in a sense, who are there to build the future.
Yeah, it's certainly been very inspiring to spend the last couple of years in the company of the Orgis leadership and of the Susan Winkle Fellows. There are some incredible people that I'm sure will go on to do some really, really incredible things.
Wonderful. We didn't mention all the projects that are involved in this, not in detail, but I'd really recommend people go to the Orgis website and look under SWF, Orgis/SWF, which is a Susan Wakil Foundation. And I think that they should really follow this up, because it's one of the great initiatives that our community is taking on and has provided for the next generation.
Yeah, I really hope they do. There's a lot of great information available online. And if anyone wants any particular information about any of the projects that have been done, they're welcome to contact me or my colleague, Timna Baker in Melbourne as well, with whom I've been working on all of them over the last couple of years.
Yeah, I saw the article with you and Timna in the Jewish News, and that's what really sparked my interest. And I'm really so happy to have met you now and also connected. I think the Sydney-Melbourne connection is very important, especially now that Melbourne's in lockdown. The only way I can connect with anybody is on Zoom. And this is a great opportunity. And thank you so much for coming on the Shtick.
Well, thank you so much for having me. It's been a pleasure, and I'm glad we would connect, even if it was only able to be via Zoom. It's been great.
Very good. Thank you so much, Harrison. And we'll be back after the break. See you then.